Now, can I start by checking that we all know why we're here?
Got no idea at all. I'm sorry. It's my son. He lives with me. I'm responsible for him. End of story. No need for any further discussion from my point of view.
Peter's a recovering alcoholic.
Yes, that's right, I am. But can we put the emphasis on recovering, please? Look, I love my son more than anything in this world, OK? Do you really want to punish him for the mistakes that I've made in the past, Leanne? He's my son. He needs to live with his dad.
The point of this meeting is to see if we can find some common ground. I'm sure you both want what's best for Simon.
Of course we do, yes.
So we agree. He is the most important person in this situation.
I know why she wants to take him away from me. She's worried about him. Yes, of course she is. But she wants to punish me.
No, she wants to punish me, and that is what this is really all about. What is best for Simon? Peter can't control his drinking. I know that better than anybody. And yes, he might love him, but that doesn't mean he's the best person to look after.
So do you think I would really hurt that kid, Leanne? Come on, answer the question. Do you think I am capable of putting him in danger, yes or no?
I think that you lead an erratic and unstable lifestyle, and I think he would be better off living with me.
I don't.
Dog or the turn of a card, was that for me?
Now, I know how difficult it is to put the pain of the breakup of the marriage aside and focus on what's best for the child.
No, look, it's not difficult, OK? It's simple. I'm sorry, I'm his dad. I'm his biological dad. Now, surely that trumps everything else.
Ask Simon who he wants to live with.
Oh, what's he going to say? He's going to want to live with the Beckhams in L.A. and I'm going to kick around with Romeo and... I don't remember his name. Look, what I'm saying is, it's not that I don't want her to see her, it's just that he lives with me.
How many times have you fallen off the wagon in the last 6 months, eh?
Let's not pretend either of us are perfect here, OK?
And why was it you admitted to a murder that you didn't even commit?
I'll tell you why, because he couldn't even remember if he'd killed somebody or not.
I'm not sure this is getting us anywhere.
Look, this is why I'll never agree to sharing custody, because she is driven by anger and resentment and jealousy.
No, excuse me, that is not what this is about. I am not jealous of you and Carla. To be honest, I couldn't care less what you do. Drink yourself to death for all I care. All I care about is what's best for Simon.
Right, so then let him live with me, because that's where he belongs. Look, I'm sorry, I just don't think this is getting us anywhere, and I want to go home and I want to see my son before he goes to bed. It was like she'd set a trap, you know, and I walked straight into it, because she knew if she pushed me buttons that I'd kick off and I'd walk out.
So what happens now?
I don't know. Go to court, I suppose. Anyway, how was he? How was Simon?
Brutal truth or the sugar-coated version?
The sugar.
Oh, he was such a little angel.
How bad was he?
Well, he's in bed. I've not opened a bottle, so we're making progress. Mm. Listen, I don't want you to worry, all right? There's no way Leanne can take him.
But it's not her. It's the lawyers.
We'll get better lawyers.
Yeah, but good lawyers, they cost big money, you know?
Ah, that won't be a problem. You see, I found myself a financial fairy godmother.
Yeah?
Sally. She's not my ideal choice of business partner, but she'd secure a stable future for the business, wouldn't she? And, well, then we could concentrate all our energies into making sure the little angel stays under our roof.